What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back with another gameplay commentary. So, you see the title of the video. We're going to be talking about the console wars over some Modern Warfare gameplay. Hope you guys enjoy this, but let's get right into it. So, I want to say yesterday, PlayStation, Sony announced their pricing for their next-gen consoles, and it's looking like the regular PlayStation 5 with the Blu-ray drive already in will be $499, and the digital version of the PlayStation 5 without the Blu-ray drive will be $399. And people were all hyped, and people was, you know, just all excited about what's to come. They announced some gameplay, or like trailer footage of like some PlayStation exclusives. Somebody's calling me in the middle of recording. I'm not editing that out. I'll probably call them back. I don't even know who that number is. But anywho, you know, people are just hyped up about it on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, everywhere. And I want to say maybe a week prior, Xbox release their pricing of their console. They're gonna have the Xbox Series X, which will be retailing at $500, pretty much $499, and then the other lower tier version they'll have releasing at $299, even cheaper than the PlayStation 5 without the Blu-ray drive. So people are already clambering on there which side they're gonna rock with: Xbox, PlayStation. People talking about, oh, PlayStation's about to win this generation. They got more exclusives, yada yada yada. And I'm just sitting here thinking, it's 2020, y'all. There shouldn't be no console war. It shouldn't even be that serious. If anything, it should be buy whatever game system you want to buy. Me personally, I am getting both. I'm gonna get the Xbox Series X first, and then I'll probably get the PlayStation 5 without the Blu-ray drive. My reasoning on getting both is, one, content reason, so I can upload different games. I'm not going to only just have Call of Duty. I may want to check out some of the PlayStation exclusives, and I have some friends on PlayStation 2, and also I have friends on Xbox as well. So it's just one of those type of things where if I'm in a situation to get both consoles, I'm gonna get both consoles. And if anything, I'll probably upgrade my setup, because right now I'm just rocking one monitor. But once I get multiple, both of the consoles, I'll probably have maybe a three monitor setup, you know. So I have the desk for it, I have a gaming desk for it, so might as well soup it up and get everything I possibly want for it, you know what I'm saying? So I really have no race in this. Like, I've never understood that, and people are really just going crazy. Oh, Xbox lost again for another console war. I'm like, I don't really care, bro. And you shouldn't care. Like, people make the comments, oh, you're on Xbox, you're on the X trash and all this other stuff. It's like, yo, it's a console, bro. If anything, if you want to be technical, PC shits on both consoles if we're talking about specs, because these consoles are coming out with better specs, but the specs have already been out for PC for a couple of years now. You know what I'm saying? So if you really want to talk about specs and graphical, like pureness, PC is obviously the way to go. But most people are not trying to spend $1,000+ on a very good PC. Even though you don't have to spend that much to have a high-end PC, people are not trying to, you know, just go into the details of finding out what you may need and stuff like that, or even wanting to build their own PC. So PC, really, they are, if you want to be technical, are like the king of just gaming. But when it comes to just strictly having a console, something easy to set up, it doesn't matter, man. Get you an Xbox, get you a PlayStation, does not matter. As long as you're having fun, that's all that really matters. As long as you're enjoying the games, that's all that matters. For those who don't know, I used to have the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox at the same time, but my PlayStation 4 just gave out on me after a while, and that's kind of what happened. So that's my route. I'm getting both of them, and I'm looking forward to it. Will I get them right away? Maybe, if I'm able to get it. I'll try to get one, the Xbox, as soon as possible. But what I've learned about consoles and when they drop, I usually kind of wait a little bit until like they get the bugs and kinks out. Because every year it happens when there's a new console that drops, especially a new generation of consoles that drop. There's always some bugs. There's always some glitches that they have to get out first. So I'll probably wait a couple months before I get it. If I'm able to get one of them as soon as it drops, then it'll definitely be the Xbox, and then I'll get the PlayStation. Because these are consoles that are supposed to last us for another 5 to 6 years. Supposed to. So we'll see. But comment down below. Let me know which consoles are you guys looking forward to. Which consoles are you getting? An Xbox or a PlayStation? Or if you guys are on PC, let me know. I'm not trying to start a console war. I just want to know your guys' preferences. It's all I care about. Why you're getting the Xbox? Why you're getting the PlayStation? Or why you're getting neither and you're sticking with your PC? Let me know. Comment down below. Or I can't forget about the Nintendo people. Let me know if you plan on getting a Nintendo Switch. Whatever. Just let me know what gaming consoles are you looking forward to getting this holiday season, man. But I'm just let the gameplay finish off in the background. Appreciate you guys' love and support. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. And I'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.